Hi, welcome back. Welcome to Solving Equations Part 3. Okay, so we're getting pretty advanced now in solving equations. So let's go ahead and try a couple that involve some topics that can be a little bit subtle to work with. Let's jump right in. Let's solve. Okay, I was thinking something like this. 5, 6, x minus 3 is equal to, okay, how about 3 halves times x minus 4? Okay, so the reason I like this problem is because we're starting off with the situation where we have a fraction multiplied by a quantity. When that's the case, what we often like to do is multiply the fraction first. So I'm going to take this 3 halves and I'm going to distribute it by x over x minus 4. And so when we, it's true that we will want to clear fractions soon, but often, when you clear fractions, you're looking for an LCD, and that process of finding an LCD is often simplified when you first perform this multiplication. And sometimes, as we're going to see in this problem, sometimes you actually get some simplification prior to that. So let's do it. The left-hand side will remain 5, 6, x minus 3, and I'm going to distribute this 3 halves. So I've got, let's see, 3 halves times x, which is just 3 halves x. And now positive 3 halves times negative 4. And a positive times a negative is a negative. Negative what? Well, 3 halves times 4 over 1. Okay, so on the left-hand side, still 5, 6, x minus 3. And on the right-hand side, well, I still have 3 halves x minus, but now 2 goes into 4. Well, once and twice. And see, now we have what? 3 times 2 is 6. Okay, so I got a little bit of simplification there. All right, so now let's go ahead and clear fractions. So I'm looking for the smallest number that both 2 and 6 go into. That would be 6. So a set of parentheses for the left and another set of parentheses for the right. And I put a 6 over 1 here and a 6 over 1 there. So now you want to distribute the 6 over 1. So it's going to be, let's see, 6 over 1 times 5, 6, x. And then positive 6 times negative 3 is negative 18. And on the right-hand side, same idea. It's going to be 3 halves x times 6 over 1. And I still have that x, don't forget that. And then negative 6 times positive 6 is negative 36. Okay, so let's see, the 6s here cancel, right? 6 and 6, I get a 1 and a 1. So I get a 5x minus 18. And on the right-hand side, well, let's see, 2 goes into 2 once, and 2 goes into 6 3 times. 3 times 3 is a 9x minus 36. So trying to get x on one side, let's subtract 9x from both sides. So I get negative 4x minus 18 equals negative 36. And now I'm going to add 18 to both sides. The left-hand side becomes negative 4x. And on the right-hand side is just negative 18. Now we're going to divide both sides by negative 4. The negative 4s cancel. And I get x is equal to, well, let's see. A negative over a negative is a positive, positive 18 fourths. And now, of course, we can reduce that. That becomes 9 over 2. And that would be my answer. X equals 9 halves. Okay, let's try another one similar in spirit where we want to clear fractions again. And this next problem illustrates another subtle issue that can arise in solving equations. Okay, let's say that you wanted to solve. All right, I was thinking something like, how about x over 2? Okay, minus x plus 3 over 3. And on the right-hand side, how about just equals 2? Okay, so what's new in this problem is that I have a sum right here in the numerator, okay, and that's going to lead to some interesting results and something we have to be kind of careful with. But in the beginning, we proceed as usual. We try to clear fractions. So I think about the LCD, which would be 6. So I'm going to multiply both sides by 6 over 1. Let's do that. So a set of parentheses for the left-hand side and a 6 over 1. And on the right-hand side, it's just 2. So I don't need to write it as 6 over 1. I can just write times 6. Okay, so as usual, we're going to distribute the 6 over 1. So it's going to be 6 over 1 times x over 2. Okay, now, positive 6 over 1, remember we think of the negative as belonging with the fraction that follows. So a positive 6 over 1 times a negative fraction, positive times a negative is going to be a negative. A negative what? Well, whatever I get when I multiply 6 over 1 times this fraction, which is x plus 3 over 3. And on the right-hand side, I just get, well, 2 times 6, which is positive 12. Okay, so for the first term, 2 goes into 2 once, 2 goes into 6 3 times, and 3 times x is 3x. And now the fun part. Well, we still have minus, right? Minus what? Well, let's see. Minus whatever we get when we multiply these together. 3 goes into 3 once, 6 goes in, or 3 goes into 6 2 times. And now I still have right here 2 multiplied by x plus 3. Now this is a product. And so what we can think of is the negative is belonging with the 2. So we can think of it with a like a minus 2, but don't forget, you have to multiply this 2 by x plus 3. Now it's not just 2 times x, it's 2 times the whole x plus 3, and that's why we need parentheses right here. Do you see that? It wasn't just 2 times x, it was 2 times the whole thing. So we put the whole quantity x plus 3 in parentheses. And in the next step, we're going to distribute that negative 2. On the right-hand side, we have 12. So here we go. It's 3x. Negative 2 times x is negative 2x. And negative 2 times positive 3 is negative 6 equals 12. So that's why you have to be careful when you have a sum here, because what happens is you end up distributing whatever you have here. It doesn't just get multiplied by the first term, it gets multiplied by both of them. Okay, now 3x minus 2x is x, minus 6 equals 12. So now I want to add 6 to both sides. And I get, on the left-hand side, I get just x, and on the right-hand side, I get 18. So x is equal to 18. And that would be my answer. Okay, so what we see is that when we have problems that involve fractions and you have sums or differences here, you have to be extra careful and remember that whatever you get when you cross cancel, that has to be distributed by the whole quantity that occurs in the numerator. And that quantity can be a sum or a difference. So you have to be on the lookout for addition or subtraction right there. Okay, stay tuned for the next video.